My mom asked me for the 1,000th time why I wanted to leave Florida and go to the boarding school that my father went to. She just didn't understand. I wanted what the poet Rabelais wanted. His last words were, "I go to seek a great perhaps." That's my answer. I don't want to die to start seeking the great perhaps. Which is why I came to Culver Creek boarding school.
Hi, I'm Chip Martin.
And your new roommate.
Hi, I'm Al Targer. Nice to meet you.
I like what you've done with the place. Classy.
Argentina, Azerbaijan, Afghanistan, Africa.
What are you doing? It's a talent of mine. I memorize things, you know, and like I repeat them. You know, normal stuff. Do you have a talent?
I remember people's last words.
People's last words?
Yeah, like for example, Hendrik Ibbens. He was a kid that he was sick for a long time. And then one morning he woke up feeling better. And even the nurse told him, "Hey, Hendrik, you have been feeling better." And then he responded, "On the contrary." And then he just died.
That's good. That's good. You know, I'm actually going to take you somewhere. But first, I'm going to have to tell you something. I mean, I guess you can say there's two types of people here in Culver Creek High School. You know, there is the popular kids who go to their mansions and their cars and their air condition and their lifestyle, their luxury, their whatever, you know. I don't like them, they don't like me, we don't get along, we don't see each other, it's okay. You know, deal with it. I don't know how you were in your other school. And I don't know how you want to be now, what type of person you want to be.
I was actually a regular kid in my public school, so.
Regular?
Yeah, regular.
You need a lot of work. Let's go to Alaska's. This is Alaska's room. She got the cigarettes.
Colonel?
Colonel? Yeah, it's what they call me.
Who is this guy not laughing at my very funny story?
This is Pudge.
No, because you're skinny.
That's Pudge. He's new. He's my roommate.
Can you get some cigarettes? That's great. Yeah.
Wanna smoke?
Yep.
Is it safe?
Not really. But the school doesn't want you to get in trouble as much as you don't want your parents to know you got in trouble.
I gotta go see my girlfriend. Bye.
So, you memorized last words?
Wanna quiz me?
JFK.
That's obvious.
Oh, is it?
Literally, someone said, "Mr. President, you can't say that Dallas doesn't love you."
That's
here's something. That's obvious. And then he got shot.
That's awful. I got one for you. Gabriel Garcia Marquez, the general in his labyrinth. It's about Timon Bolivar. He was in a headlock race, and the rest was darkness. He said, "Damn it, how will I ever get out of this labyrinth?"
What was the labyrinth?
That's the mystery, isn't it? Is the labyrinth living or dying? Is it trying to escape the world or the end of it?
I have no idea.
I'll make you a deal. Figure out what the labyrinth is, and I will get you a girlfriend.
Deal.
So, Butch, this is our secret hiding spot. He's part of the group. Did you know that you're in the presence of the sickest MC ever?
Drop a sick beat, Colonel Catastrophe. Right here, you want me to kick it? If you smoke with popsicles, I definitely lick it. Sometimes I'm accused of being a showman. I can rhyme really fast and I can rhyme really slow, man. Yeah.
So Alaska, why do you smoke so fast?
You all smoke to enjoy it. I smoke to die.
I know this might be an obvious answer, but why Alaska?
Well, my mom was kind of a hippie and my dad a Republican. My mom wanted to call me Harmony and my dad wanted to call me Mary. So they called me Mary until I was 7 and I got to choose my own name. So I spent the whole day looking at the globe until I finally decided for Alaska.
But why Alaska?
At the time, I just saw Alaska there, big, like I wanted to be. And it was far away from Bayan Station, like I wanted to be.
At least you got away from home.
It's not easy getting away. But I don't want to be one of those people that sit around talking about their future. I'm just gonna do it.
What?
You spend your whole life stuck in the labyrinth and thinking of how you will escape it someday. But you never do it. You just use the future to escape the present.
Sometimes I don't get you.
That's the whole point. Are you staying home for vacations? Because I have composed a list.
A list?
Reasons and why you should stay for vacations. May Alaska ya.
I'll convince my parents, but why are you staying?
I'm scared of ghosts, Pudge, and home is full of them. You know what? It's not life or death, the labyrinth.
So then, what is it?
It's about suffering, doing wrong things, having bad things happen to you. Bolivar was talking about pain, and how do you get out of the labyrinth of suffering? There's always suffering in the world, homework, malaria, or a long-distance relationship. Suffering is universal.
If I drink one more sip, I think I want to throw up. Nobody's pouring alcohol down your throat.
I have an idea. Let's play best day and worst day. It's a game I just made up. Everybody tells their best day of their lives and the worst day of their lives, and the winner doesn't have to drink. Was also my worst day. Best day, January 9, 1997. I went with my mom to the zoo. She liked the bears, I liked the monkeys. End of the story.
That's your best day? Lame.
But why was it your worst day?
When I got home, I was in my room. I heard a scream and went downstairs. My mom was laying on the floor. I should have called 911, but I panicked and just sat there. When my dad got back home, she was plenty dead. I win, you drink.
Sorry.
So, Pudge, tell me, why do you like last words so much?
I don't know. Sometimes they're funny, but a lot of times it just tells me about what people were. Most times, people die how they live.
I think I'm drunk.
So, what are those flowers for?
It's just for my anniversary with Jake.
Just help me get out of here.
What happened?
I'm always doing everything wrong. I don't know what happened. I just have to go. Please help me distract the guardian teacher.
Okay. Start
the car. We'll the second firework. You'll go. You wanted to see us?
You're not in trouble. Something terrible has happened. I need to speak with you.
What? What's it about?
I was asked to inform you that last night, Alaska Young was in a horrible accident. She was killed. Alaska has passed away. I'm really sorry. I talked to the police. They said they smelled alcohol. She hit the police car without swerving. She must have been very intoxicated. She had some white daisies in the car. That was it. No sign of anything else on what might have happened to her. It was instant. I'm really sorry.
So, what are we looking for?
Anything that's ours and that you don't want any adults seeing.
God, look at all these books that she could have read. Look for the general in his labyrinth. With the green cover.
Is it this one?
She wrote something at the back.
Straight and fast.
The way out of the labyrinth, I suppose.
Wait, repeat how it happened.
She ran into a cop car, and she was so drunk, she didn't even swerve.
So drunk? The cop car would have had its lights on. She ran into a cop car that had its lights on, Pudge. Straight and fast. She put an end to her labyrinth.
So that's it, Alaska. You just can't make me different and then leave me. I was fine the way I was, with my lame school friends and my last words. And now you just leave me? You left me for hapless, stuck in your goddamn labyrinth.